had a few match points and then eventually went to the third. What do you think made the difference today against Daniel?
Oh, I think a lot of things made a big difference today. Yeah, I mean, I could have definitely finished the match a little bit earlier, which was the plan. But of course, not everything goes in that manner. I think resilient. I was very resilient throughout the whole match, and I was looking for the match. I always wanted to create the game. I was trying to create my plays and go after the shots. I think last week was I think they also gave me a lot of insight of the things that I can do better and things that I wanted to do better. And yeah, a difficult one today, but I'm very happy that I you know, managed to also hold on to my emotions and keep going after my game.
Good luck, Daniel. You saved a lot of match points. What do you think made the difference in the final set tiebreak?
He played better, good return on 1-0. Could I do better? I'm not even sure. Bad mistake at 2-0, but that's mostly it. Other than that, he made some winners and played good points. Served well. So on the tiebreak, not much to say. I'm happy the way I fought. I managed to raise my level during the match. So in a way, for sure, very disappointed with the match and the result, but don't see much I could do better. And I feel like I played a good match. So probably should try to stay positive.
You didn't show any frustration, and just mentally, how do you think you finished that one without, you know, losing your mind out there?
Yeah, I lost my legs on that one. It's tough to think too for something else. I think, you know, like I was even talking to my team now. I thought I could have hit a few shots differently, but every time, for example, I was setting up to hit a backhand, and instead of leaning forward, I was leaning backwards, and I was thinking, what's going on here?
When you've been booed, why is that you choose not to play, and how did you feel about the crowd today in particular?
So what happened is I throw the racket, I get booed, normal. I don't see a problem with it. I go to serve, they applause or something, but I want to serve, so they shouldn't applause, so I still serve. The referee was talking during this, so Grigor was not ready. Okay, that happens, but I get booed. I didn't see why, so I didn't want to play. And that's actually the end of the story. And then I was like, okay, till they boo, I'm not going to play. But Bercy crowd doesn't stop to boo. So I was like, okay. And then when I got a code, I was like, do I really want to get disqualified and finish the match on this note? No, so I went to play.
What about your relationship with the French tennis public? I mean, you live in France, you speak fluent French. That normally makes you very popular. And you've had a lot of support here. Or is it nothing to do with France? Is it the kind of thing that could happen anywhere?
Yeah, I think, first of all, as you say, kind of doesn't really have to do anything with France or not France. I think it just depends the tournament, the way I act, the way the crowd acts. So it's like all coming together. In general, I have a lot of French friends, and they don't seem to like very much this tournament. So maybe there is a reason. Me, generally, yeah, I played much better here without the crowd, so that's all I can say.
I'm proud of the team. This is the one thing that I'm the most, in a way, happy with. Wins are win. Of course, when they come, they're happy and positive. But we all had a different vision, you know, like the bigger picture. And I think right now we just kind of enjoy that run, you know, in the past like 3-4 months, because we know what we have done. And we want that. We want to be in those positions. We want to play those matches, and we want to have that grind.
In part was 2017, when you played so well at this time of year, and we all expected great things of you in 2018, and you started a bit flat.
Yeah.
Have you learned something from that that means you can continue the last few months into next year?
Oh, my God, you gave me back at 2018. It's about to be 2024. Yeah, I've learned. Oh my God, I don't know where should I begin from with the learning process. I think I've been in school ever since then. So yeah, I guess. I mean, if I don't know, in 14 years, if I don't learn every single season that I have, I mean, shame on me. But in the same time, there's so many factors, and I think often a lot of us, and even us as players, forget about things and. You take certain things for granted, and things happen outside the tennis life. And, you know, there's so many like fundamentals that sometimes don't go you know, don't go your way, and they affect you, of course, on the court as well. So balance, and I think that's why I think you have the right, you need to have the right team, the family, friends, and you know, it takes time. It takes time, but that's why I think overall my career and moments have been a lot of up and down, and I'm recognizing this, and I'm in a way proud of it, because it made me who I am today, and it made me learn things and make me understand people better, made me understand myself better, and yeah, you keep on moving and you learn.